Namaste students, welcome back to the class. Today I am going to continue chapter 6, more on internet, email, e-commerce. You will take out page number 92. We are going to see this topic, sending an email using a tablet. In my previous video, I have shown you and I have teach you till the topic sign out. Now let us see this topic. You can also send an email using a tablet. How? Let us see. Make sure that you are connected to the internet. Tap the Chrome icon. You have to click on the Google Chrome icon and then this window will appear. Here you have to type www.gmail.com using the virtual keyboard. This is the virtual keyboard. And then you have to click on Go button. Then after that, what you have to do, this window will appear. Over here, you have to type the username. It will ask for the username. Write down whatever the username @gmail.com. Then click on next. Enter the password in the appropriate box and tap sign in button. See, you have to type the password over here and then click on sign in button. Your account window appears. The window is divided into two panes, left pane and right pane. See this. The account window will appear. This is the left pane and this is the right pane. Okay. And after that, you have to click over here. One icon is there. That is, type the content of the message in the space provided. You have to click over here. Then only it will show this box. It will open up. Box will open up. Over there, you have to type the message. What message you want to send. You have to type out the message. You have to enter the email address of the receiver, enter the subject, and then type out the message, and then click on this send button. You can also send pictures, videos, and other document as an attachment through your email using a tablet. Now the next topic, e-commerce. What is an e-commerce? Commerce is a process of buying and selling a product. There are three different types of people involved in this process. Producers, who produce different kind of products and provide services. Sellers, who sell product and offer services to people. Buyers, who purchase items and services. So there are three different types of people. Like, if you want to buy a rice, you are going to a shop, you are asking to the shopkeeper. From the shopkeeper, you are buying the rice, right? Who is the producer? The farmer is the producer, right? In the same way, if you want to buy a cloth, the cloth industries, they are the producer, they are producing it, selling, and the seller is what? The garment shop, right? From there, we are buying. So, there are three different types of people involved. Producers, sellers, and buyers. And what is e-commerce? Electronic commerce or e-commerce means buying and selling product online using the internet. Many companies have set up their website which provide the facility to purchase their product and service online. Some of the e-commerce websites are Snapdeal.com, Flipkart.com, Amazon.com, CordovaJoyFullLearning.com. So these are the different e-commerce websites. So over here you will be getting the product. You can choose the product. If you don't get it, then you can search for the another website. So over here you can choose any one of the product and you can buy it from their website. Method of payment in e-commerce. The key feature of e-commerce is to make payment online. There is also a facility of cash on delivery, COD, which helps you to make payment after receiving the product. In case of online payment, internet banking is used. So when you are buying something, you might have seen, if you are using the Flipkart or the Amazon, you can see over there, after choosing the product, what you have to do, how you have to make a payment. Either you have to make a payment using the debit card or the credit card or the internet banking, or there is an option that is cash on delivery. That means when the delivery will be done, you can pay the cash to the person who is delivering the product, right? So, in case of online payment, internet banking is used. That is using the UPI payment, using the Bheem app, using the GPay, using the debit card, credit card, all these are falling under the online payment option. See, now let us see the advantage and disadvantage of e-commerce. You can buy product even sitting at home. You do not need to go to the showroom or shop to buy product. But disadvantage is that you cannot check the quality of some product. Like if you are going to a shop, you can check the quality. But sitting at home, you can buy the product, but the quality you cannot check. You do not need to carry cash from home to shop. The disadvantage is, sometimes the product you receive may be different from the one you ordered. It happened. Many times it happened that whatever product you have ordered, the product will be different from whatever you have ordered. It happened to many persons. So there is a risk also. And there's the advantages that you don't have to carry the cash. Directly you can pay it when the cash on delivery option you can choose, or you can pay it using the online payment option. You do not need to search items manually with the help of a salesperson. The product may get damaged while being transported. Over here, what is happening? Like you are going to a shop and you want to find something, you need to ask to a person over there, right? So in an e-commerce platform, you don't have to ask to any person. You can search it by yourself by typing what you want. You can search it and you can buy it. And another disadvantage is that the product may get damaged while coming. The parcel is done. When you're receiving it, you may receive a damaged product. Okay. Advantage, another advantage, there is no time limits. You can sit at home, take your time and do the shopping. You can save time, money and effort. And in the disadvantage, it is risky at time to do internet banking. Yes, sometimes it is very dangerous and it's risky also while using the internet banking. So students, these are the advantage of e-commerce and disadvantages of the e-commerce that we have learned. You will learn more about e-commerce and e-payments later in the next classes. So students, this is the end of the video. With this video, this chapter is completed. Go through all the video and read the chapter. Thank you. Namaste.